Hello everybody, it's me, Unfriendly Porcupine, and today I'm going to show you how to get the He-Man or Faker haircut onto a Call of Duty figure. So that way you can create an awesome haircut like this Call of Duty soldier right here. Here is the piece. See, it has a T-Peg system. T-Peg and T-Peg are compatible. This Faker figure right here also is on a T-Peg system. So, if you want the T-Peg to be compatible, all you have to do, slide it on, and now you have the figures that are compatible with the T-Peg system. So that's awesome! Now, what you essentially have is amazing haircuts for your figures, for your Call of Duty figures. That is awesome! The customization potential is insane here, especially if you color the haircuts different color. Now, what do you guys think? Do you guys think it would be super awesome if Mega Constructs made different type of hair colors or different type of hair pieces, all compatible with Call of Duty system? Let me know in the comment section down below, because I think that's an idea that has to happen. It could be an awesome thing, and I think it would be the absolute way to fix that annoying T-Peg system, because now you would just have a different haircut instead. Now you're probably wondering, how the hell do I get this hair mold off? Because if you actually bought this set, you would know that the hairpiece just does not come off. Well, that's because Mega Constructs had the bright idea to glue it. So if you're not careful, this can happen. You see that? That's what the glue does. Yeah, you might actually rip off the whole entire T-Peg thing. And ay caramba, that's a big problem. Now, why did Mega Constructs glue the hairpiece to the head mold? Well, I think it's because they wanted to save on the costs of actually painting the hairpiece if it was all one mold. I think that was the original idea, and they never intended you to take off the hairpiece because it was intended to be one mold. They just didn't feel like spending more money on painting the hairpiece, so they had the idea of, why don't we make them two separate pieces so we don't have to paint them? I just wish they were still not glued, so it'd be so much easier for customs like this. But since they had to glue it, what do we do? Well, let me show you. Now this, of course, absolutely works with the He-Man figure or the Faker figure. I'm going to use the Faker figure right here since I can't find my He-Man figures. So, how did this work? I first, of course, already took off the hairpiece, and that's how it looks like inside, you see? There's still a little bit of glue residue in there, but I mostly got it cleaned up. So, how do you get this thing taken off? Well, you might have to actually use this to kind of push it out, and you have to also dig in with your nails. So yeah, it is gonna be a pain in the ass to actually get this removed. So much so that this happened. Okay. So you might want to start by loosening the hairpiece a little bit, moving it around and slowly taking it off. Another thing you can do right here is you can also put this piece in there to kind of create a little bit of an anchor. You see, once you can get that piece starting to pull, that's how you do it. Unfortunately, you also have to be careful not to rip the piece, but you're just trying to deglue it. So it's a pain in the ass, absolutely. Pain in the buttocks, pain in the butthole, pain in the whatever you want to call it. Remember, if you're getting frustrated, blame Mega Construct, because they had the bright idea to glue this.
But don't blame me.
I blame you.
As you can see right there, we are almost done. Damn. Damn, bro. I'm actually already sweaty. Damn, look what your stupid glue did, Mega Constructs. Right here, we specifically found the area in which it has been glued. So that's the part we're actually going to have to cut out a little bit with this piece. That's the last final blow that we need to give this thing. And then from there, we're good to go. You have to find it in there. You can see, you can see already, it's already kind of starting to crack a little bit in there. So we might not be able to get Faker completely nicely. And it might just have to be like that. We shall see, we shall see. Next, once you got it very, very loose and you're very close, you just need to poke it in the front and then kind of lift it up a little bit. Create some loose space in there. What essentially you're doing here is you're kind of cutting the glue with this piece, but making sure not to damage the plastic too much. It's kind of like a technique.
Oh, come on!
Damn it! Yeah, unfortunately, it looks like we're gonna have to make a Faker like this 2.0. Cause it's just way too damn difficult. You're just gonna have to cut that part out. Unfortunately, it is a bummer, but that might be the only way you can get that head mold.
Oh, boom! There we go! We got it!
We finally fucking got it! Okay, yeah, I know what it is. It looks like one big mess. And what has happened to the head mold? Well, that's the only way to actually get it out. So now, the next step is to just carve all of that out. So, yeah, it's gonna take me a while. Yeah, and also one more thing, the Faker head mold right here is actually way much more harder to take out. To get this hairpiece off of Mr. Faker, it's a very painstaking process. You have to pull the hair out, you have to make sure that it doesn't rip it off, which has already happened, Yeah. Especially Mr. Faker, since Mr. Faker has it really badly glued. Once you get it off there, it might not be possible to actually get the T-peg still on Mr. Faker. So what you have to do next is then you have to scratch all of those parts out, either with pliers or with a pin. Then you finally get your head mold that you can use for all other fun custom stuffs. There probably is maybe an easier way to dissolve the glue, but as for now, I don't know. If you guys know an easier way to do this, post it in the comment section down below. Other than that, my comrades, I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to leave it a like. And as always, my comrades, if you want to see more content, like awesome tutorials, awesome custom builds, you know what to do. Hit the subscribe button and I'll catch you in the next video. Take care, my comrades.